I am here in New Orleans, where we have an annual meeting in hematology and oncology, in which my colleagues they describe, discuss all data presented in major congress around the world, including ASCO, which is the American Society for Clinical Oncology, ASH, ESMO, the European Society of Medical Oncology, and others, congress such as a World Lung Cancer Congress, and the Breast Cancer Symposium, and others. So this meeting has been developed in the last 12 years. I am the program director and the chair of the meeting. And in this opportunity, I was able to discuss immunotherapy in lung cancer. So basically, what I will present is the data in which immunotherapy has moved to the front line in the management of lung cancer. Right now, our lung cancer patient has they have the possibility to receive immunotherapy as a monotherapy and leave the chemotherapy for later on. And just recently, in May of this year, the FDA approved the combination of chemotherapy known as carboplatin plus pemetrexed in combination with pembrolizumab. So now our stage 4 lung cancer has two options in the front line to improve their overall survival. Also, I will present data from Memorial Sloan Kettering on a clinical trial using the combination of nivolumab plus ipilimumab in small cell lung cancer, confirming what has been previously described in terms of better response rate for this population. Still, we are waiting for the final data on overall survival and progression-free survival. Also, in this opportunity, I will be able to clarify many concepts and what to do with patients that they have expression of a biomarker called PD-L1, which stands for programmed death ligand 1, and how this PD-L1 interact with other mutation in the lung cancer, such as the epidermal growth factor receptor, EGFR, or the anaplastic lymphoma kinase abnormality known as ALK, others such as KRAS, STK11, MET exon 14, and many others. So this is very important because when we have a patient that is able to receive target therapy for this driver mutation, how can we implement or how can we put immunotherapy in this patient? So the data continue developing and the clinical trials continue giving us more information on how to handle this special population in lung cancer. So these are basically what I want to discuss in the New Orleans Summer Cancer Meeting on the immunotherapy session in lung cancer.